Hey guys, welcome to Tots and Moms. My name is Kavita. In today's video, I'm going to talk about UTI in babies, a very common concern, and you know how it is difficult with a baby. Even for a fever, when they suffer, we cannot see them, and this is something we cannot inspect immediately. So there are certain symptoms and signs that you can check and ensure that your baby is taken care of and does not go weak or suffer a lot. So do watch the video till the end. I'm talking about symptoms, I'm talking about treatment and prevention. And if you're watching the video for the first time on our channel, let me tell you, on Tots and Moms, we keep sharing a lot of baby health, baby care videos, mom's care videos, and a lot of baby food recipes would be posted here. So subscribe and click on the bell icon. Let me tell you about urinary tract to begin with. It is made of kidney, ureters, then bladder and urethra. And this infection is spread through urine, and it can pass on to bladder, and the infection can spread till kidney. Now, in case, most of the time it is spread through the germs which are on the skin of the child, and this is spread through the poop. So it does not mean that you are not hygienic, but it can easily pass through poop, through urethra to the bladder. Symptoms in older children can be observed, like pain in the belly area and regular peeing more than usual, and a pinkish urine which says that the blood is being passed. And even when they have control over bladder, they start bedwetting. So these are in older children, and in babies, when they really can't talk, we have to be very careful and get deep and check if they are crying while they are peeing, and they are not peeing at once, a little at a time, because they are unable to do that, or it is hurting them, and nausea, diarrhea, having fever. So all these can be symptoms in babies. The only way to recognize UTI would be through urine test. Generally, this is the one recommended, but for further investigation, to check on if there are any blockages and to check the kidney functioning, they may ask for renal ultrasound scan. They may also ask for MRI or neural scan. Not to worry, most of the time it is cured through antibiotics, but doctor is the best judge. Most important part of the video on how to prevent UTI in babies and children. At first, you will have to ensure that you keep changing diapers more often, at least 2 hours once. And then early potty training is important here to stop the infection, because otherwise it is left out in the diaper for a while, you do not observe it. Yeah, there are chances that you miss out to observe, and the infection can easily spread. And clean their genital area more often. Whenever they pee, at least with a little water or through a wet cloth, avoid soap as much as possible, even during bathing. And for older children, you can tell them to keep peeing whenever they have the urge to, and not to control it at any cost. And let them take a lot of fluids. This will prevent it to an extent. And for babies, and breastfeeding and formula feeding is the best remedy. So even when you are very conscious, highly hygienic, this can spread, as I already said. So do not fret. Antibiotics can treat it within a week or so, and it is high in baby girl when compared to baby boys. And I will not get deep into why and all, but this is how it is. And these were simple details which you can know, and further you can take advice from doctor. So I hope you got enough details out of this video. If you like the content, please click on the bell icon and subscribe to our channel. And I'll see you soon in yet another video. On our next topic, we'll be talking about gestational diabetes. Hope to see you back again. Bye-bye.